Here in this lecture, we are going to discuss about the anatomy of the posterior intercostal arteries. We know that between each rib, we have intercostal spaces. So, every intercostal space supplied by a pair of intercostal arteries, that is anterior intercostal arteries as well as posterior intercostal arteries. So, there are totally 11 pairs of intercostal arteries. So, out of all this, if you see in this image, this is the anterior aspect and this is the posterior aspect, because the image is the superior view. Anteriorly, we have a sternum, and behind the sternum, you can see the internal thoracic artery. The internal thoracic artery is the first branch of the, or we can say the branch of the first part of the subclavian artery, right? So, this is the internal thoracic artery. And this internal thoracic artery gives off branches called as anterior intercostal arteries, right? So, anterior intercostal arteries are the branches of internal thoracic artery, which is a branch of subclavian artery. But when we talk about the posterior intercostal arteries, we can see this is the descending aorta or descending thoracic aorta. The descending thoracic aorta on either side gives off the right posterior intercostal artery as well as the left posterior intercostal artery. As you can see in this image, by seeing this image, we can say very clearly that the right posterior intercostal artery is the longest or longer when compared to that of the left posterior intercostal arteries. Okay. And as I already said that there are totally 11 pairs of intercostal arteries, but if you see, the posterior intercostal arteries are the one which supply greater part of the intercostal spaces, right? Because the anterior intercostal artery has a very minute contribution, but if you see, approximately greater than 90% of the intercostal space supplied by these posterior intercostal arteries. So, now we need to see all the intercostal arteries based on this particular image. First, we have the first as well as second intercostal spaces are supplied by, or the first as well as second intercostal spaces receives arterial supply from superior intercostal artery by its branches. For example, this is the superior intercostal artery. This one is the superior intercostal artery. The superior intercostal artery arises from a trunk called as costo-cervical trunk. This is the costo-cervical trunk. Remember that the costo-cervical trunk gives off two branches. One is the deep cervical artery and another one is the superior, that is superior intercostal artery, which is also called as supreme intercostal artery. So, the supreme intercostal artery gives off two branches for first as well as second intercostal spaces. So, that is the reason we need to remember that the first as well as second intercostal spaces are supplied by the superior intercostal artery, which is the descending branch of the costocervical trunk, and this particular costocervical trunk arises from the second part of the subclavian artery, right? Let me repeat once again. The second part of the subclavian artery gives off costocervical trunk. The costocervical trunk gives off two branches. One is deep cervical artery and another one is superior intercostal artery, which is also called as supreme intercostal artery. The supreme intercostal artery gives off two branches for first as well as second intercostal spaces, which means first as well as second intercostal spaces does not receive its vascular supply from the branches of the descending thoracic aorta. from third. For example, if you see third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth, tenth, as well as 11th. The 12th one is the subcoastal artery. We cannot say the 12th one is the intercoastal artery. So we have totally 11 intercoastal arteries. That is 11 posterior intercoastal arteries, which are supplying the greater part of the intercoastal spaces. The first and second intercoastal spaces receive its vascular supply from the superior intercoastal artery, right? Or superior intercoastal artery, which is a branch of the costocervical trunk. But from 3rd to 11th onwards, it is mainly the branches are arising from the descending thoracic aorta over here, right? So now let us discuss about the overall anatomy of the arch of aorta as well as the subclavian artery. This is the arch of aorta. The arch of aorta gives off three branches, right? First, second, third, three branches. The first branch of the arch of aorta is called as brachiocephalic trunk, right? This is the brachiocephalic trunk. So the brachiocephalic trunk in turn gives off two branches, right? One is the right common carotid artery and right subclavian artery. This is the right subclavian artery. So the right subclavian artery, so the right side of the hand, right? So right hand. So the right subclavian artery arising from the brachiocephalic trunk, not directly from the arch of aorta. The same thing with the right common carotid artery arising from the brachiocephalic trunk. But whereas if you see the left common carotid artery, left common carotid artery arises from the arch of aorta as a second branch. And the third branch of the arch of aorta is the left subclavian artery. Understand? So we have the left subclavian artery, right subclavian artery, right common carotid artery arising from brachiocephalic trunk, and left common carotid artery arising directly from the arch of aorta. So this is what we need to know about the anatomy of the subclavian artery over here. So from 3rd to 11th posterior intercoastal arteries are arising from descending thoracic aorta. This is what we need to remember over here. Now let us discuss about the course as well as the relations of the posterior intercoastal arteries over here. So here the right posterior intercoastal arteries, which are arising from the descending thoracic aorta, are longer when compared to that of the left posterior intercoastal arteries. The main reason is, as you can see in this picture, that the descending thoracic aorta is the one which lies on the left side as well as anterior to the vertebral column. That is the reason the right one is longer when compared to that of the left. So now let us discuss about the course of the right as well as left separately. Now first let us discuss about the course of the right posterior intercoastal artery. So this is the right posterior intercoastal artery, which is arising from the descending thoracic aorta over here. Once it arises from the descending thoracic aorta, it runs behind the esophagus. So this is the esophagus, behind the thoracic duct, behind the azygous vein, behind the sympathetic chain, right? So what is this? This is the esophagus, this is the thoracic duct, right? This is the azygous vein and sympathetic chain. So behind all these structures, it runs, right? Posteriorly, it takes an arch and it runs forwards and anteriorly through the spaces called as intercoastal spaces. Okay, when we talk about the left posterior intercoastal artery over here, the left posterior intercoastal arteries are smaller when compared to that of the right, right? But it runs behind hemiazygous vein, right side azygous vein, left side hemiazygous vein, right? Runs behind hemiazygous vein, behind the sympathetic chain, but in front and side of the vertebral body. So this is the course of the right as well as left posterior intercostal arteries. As you can see the posterior intercostal artery very clearly, this posterior intercostal artery divides into anterior as well as posterior rami. So this is the anterior rami, this one is the anterior rami, and this one is the posterior rami. The posterior rami is also called as dorsal rami. It is also called as the dorsal branch. So each and every posterior intercostal artery divides into anterior ramus as well as posterior ramus, right? But in the intercostal space, if you see, in the intercostal space, the anterior rami of the posterior intercostal artery runs between the intercostal vein above as well as the intercostal nerve below. So vein is above and the nerve is below, and the artery runs between these two structures to form a neurovascular bundle in the intercostal spaces called as vein, artery and nerve. So we can say with the mnemonic called as VAN. So the neurovascular bundle in the intercostal spaces are intercostal vein, posterior intercostal artery as well as intercostal nerve. These three structures which runs forwards in the intercostal space forms neurovascular bundle. Now let us discuss about the termination. The posterior intercostal arteries ends at the level of costochondral junction by anastomosing with the anterior intercostal artery, which is a branch of internal thoracic artery. So this is the course as well as relation of the posterior intercostal arteries. Now let us discuss finally about the branches. The first one is the dorsal branch. We know that the posterior intercostal artery is giving a dorsal ramus, which is also called as a dorsal branch, as well as anterior ramus. So the dorsal ramus, which runs posteriorly, supplies the spinal cord, supplies the vertebra, muscles, as well as skin of the back. And another branch we have, this one is the collateral branch. We have another branch called as a collateral branch. And we have numerous muscular branches. These muscular branches, which are arising from the posterior intercostal artery, supply the intercostal muscles, pectoral muscles, as well as the serratus anterior also. And we also have the lateral cutaneous branches on either side. So these lateral cutaneous branches has a cutaneous innervation. And the extra branches, if we discuss, we have mammary branches, which are also called as external mammary arteries, which arise from the posterior intercostal arteries, especially from second, third, as well as fourth intercostal spaces, especially to supply the breast, which is also called as the mammary gland. And another branch, which is called as the right bronchial artery. The right bronchial artery arises only from the right third posterior intercostal artery. So these are the branches of the posterior intercostal artery. So by this, we completed the detailed anatomy of the posterior intercostal arteries.